My father would have beaten a famous roll this evening, and now I must do it. And he beat a thundering roll call on the instrument, and the drum felt so highly honored that the parchment burst with exultation.
"He has a splendid touch," said the drum. "I've a remembrance of him now that will last. I expect that the same thing will happen to his mother, from pure joy over her golden treasure."
And this is the story of the golden treasure. The Darning Needle by Hans Christian Andersen. There was once a darning needle who thought herself so fine that she fancied she must be fit for embroidery. "Hold me tight," she would say to the fingers when they took her up. "Don't let me fall. If you do, I shall never be found again. I am so very fine." "That is your opinion, is it?" said the fingers as they seized her around the body. "See, I am coming with a train," said the darning needle, drawing a long thread after her, but there was no knot in the thread. The fingers then placed the point of the needle against the cook's slipper. There was a crack in the upper leather, which had to be sewn together. "What coarse work," said the darning needle. "I shall never get through. I shall break. I am breaking." And sure enough, she broke. "Did I not say so?" said the darning needle. "I know I am too fine for such work as that." "This needle is quite useless for sewing now," said the fingers, but they still held it fast, and the cook dropped some sealing wax on the needle and fastened her handkerchief with it in front.